Welcome to Syntax Error. I'm Pratiksha Jain, and in this video, we're going to understand the difference about mutable and immutable data. For this video, I'm using Python IDLE, the IDLE which you get when you download the Python itself. Okay, so mutable means changeable, and immutable means non-changeable. This means that the data which is stored, and if it is mutable, then you can change that data. You can remove, you can add, you can append more and more data. You can do whatever you want. But in immutable, it means that you cannot change the position of that data. So let us start. Suppose I have assigned a value 1 to variable A. Now let me print ID of A. This means the memory location of A. This is the memory location of A, which stores 1 in it. Now, if I do the same, let me store 56. Now, let me print ID of A. What do you guys think? It going to print the same or going to print the different? Because this A variable is only pointing to 1 and 56. Have a think. Let me just print. See, both the memory locations are different because Python says that I'm going to allow A, that is a variable, to point to two different memory locations, but I'm not going to allow it to override the memory location. That means 56 cannot override the memory location of A, but it will allow variable A to point to two different memory locations. This is an example of immutable data. That means the memory location of a data can't be changed. Means the memory location and the writes can't be taken from value. Okay, this was an example of immutable. Let's go for mutable now. Suppose I have a list and I have stored these values in a list. Let's print the ID of list. This is the ID right now. Now, let us append some new values to list. So, lst dot append. This is a function. This is a way to write when you want to append a value to list. So, I'm writing x. Make a note that I am appending a value. I'm not replacing any value. So this 7 will be placed after 6. Let me just print lst. See, the 7 got added after 6. Now let me print the ID of lst. Now think for a second again whether the ID will remain the same or whether it will change. Okay, so the ID is same yet. Why this is so? Because this is an example of mutable data. That means changeable data. This means that the data inside a list or a tuple or a dictionary can be changed, but its memory location remains the same. But in this case, the memory location was different for 1 and 56. But if I put the same data in the list, that is 1 and 56, then the memory location will remain the same. What do you mean by this? This means that the memory location of data type can't be changed. List is a data type and that list has been assigned to this memory location. Now, whatever I make changes to the list, let me remove something. I need to pass a variable. Suppose I remove 1. Let's print my list and let's print the ID again. See, 1 got removed, but my memory location is yet the same. This is because the data types memory location can't be changed even if there are no values in that data type. This is a new list that I have. Let us print the ID quickly. Let us append a list into this and then let's see What happens? Does the ID changes of the list or the ID remains the same? Let us print the list first. See, the new list got appended inside the existing list. Now let's check for the ID. The memory location remains the same. Even if you remove the elements, even if you append new elements, try to append tuple to this list. Then let's see what happens. Let's take any number. Let's print L again. See, the tuple got added and even the list got added. Let us create a new list and then let us try to merge those lists and then let's see what will be the ID of that list. Oops. This is my list right now. The ID of this list is this, and my previous list is this. Now let's append this list to my existing list. So let us just do it. Now let us check the ID. Let us first print the list. This is my list now. These two elements I got from LST list. Now let us print the ID. I'll be printing the ID of L because I have extended my L list, not LST list, LST name list. See, the ID again remains the same. There are no changes into memory location because we are storing the data at the same memory location. Now, if I talk about tuple, let's take a tuple. I can store a tuple like 1, 2, 5, 6 with commas, or I can store a tuple with round brackets. ID of the tuple. Now, if you want to add element to a tuple, then firstly you need to convert that tuple into a list and then only you can add the element. So let us try to convert the tuple into the list first. Let us append. Takes only one argument. I'm so sorry. Okay, now let us convert our tuple that we converted into list back again to tuple. So I'll be doing like tuple is equal to tuple and TUP. There shouldn't be double P. Now let us print tuple first. 87 got appended. There's a difference in new ID of tuple and in the previous ID of tuple. This means that tuple is immutable. You can't change the values inside a tuple when it gets stored. Immutable is non-changeable. Non-changeable, once the value is assigned, the memory location can't be taken away by any other variable. Means you can't override it, you can't replace it, you can't do anything about it. But immutable, it is changeable. You can change the values, but the memory location of the data type remains the same. If any of the questions, then make a note in comment box.